Until the Supreme Court hears that case, university students in Oregon will have to accept a level of uncertainty.
That is the word today from the president at Portland State University. Chris Willis sat down with him today, and Chris, Vim Vivel says this sends the wrong message.
Yeah, he does, and it's going to take some time, too. It's likely the court will not hear this until October, and that leaves months of speculation for international students. There are about 28,000 students at Portland State. 80 of them are from the six countries included in President Trump's executive order. They are not expected to be affected by this. They will be allowed to continue to stay here and study. In fact, the court said until it hears arguments on the order's constitutionality, people in Iran, Syria, Libya, Somalia, Sudan, and Yemen with a bona fide relationship with a legal resident of the United States will be excluded from the travel ban. But the message is wrong, according to university officials. They say it's not a good one and creates a lot of ambiguity.
In the longer run, I'm sure this will have a negative effect on people coming to the United States to study, which is not just like it's an economic effect for us. It's just bad for the country. Again, this country was built on immigrants. Let's not close the door on them.
President Trump says as commander-in-chief, his number one responsibility is to keep the American people safe. And he wants better vetting on those coming from terror-related countries, as he calls them. Lower courts and attorneys general have argued Trump's executive order amounts to nothing more than a religious test for the people coming to the United States, as the six countries in his order are predominantly Muslim.